now we will discuss about the two subfamilies characters in the Asclepiadaceae family. Those two subfamilies are classified based on the arrangement of the pollinia in those two subfamilies. Those two subfamilies are Periplocaridae and also Sinencaridae. First we will discuss about the Periplocaridae. Periplocaridae characteristics along with pollination also. Clearly listen and listen carefully. This topic is very important in this family. Then in this Periplocaridae, once clearly observe this diagram, all of you. In this diagram, see the floral diagram. See this floral diagram only. In this floral diagram, we have to observe the outer layer. This outer layer is known as calyx. In this, once again I repeat, this entire diagram is belongs to the Periplocaridae subfamily of Asclepiadaceae. Example is Cryptostegia plant. This is Cryptostegia plant. In this diagram, keen observed in this diagram, floral diagram, sepals are 5 in numbering. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In this 5 in numbering of the sepals are free in arrangement. There is no fusion. See this, there is no fusion. These 5 sepals are gamosepalous. Then second row is petals. This is corolla. This entire oath is corolla. The second row also absorb 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again, these petals also are 5 in numbering. These petals are fused with themselves. See this diagram, one petal to another petal. These petals are fused with one to another. So these 5 petals, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these 5 petals are fused with themselves only. And also next, third row is stamens. See these stamens. These stamens are also in 5 in numbering. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But in this picture, we have to observe one matter. In this picture, 5 stamens are present. These 5 stamens are alternative to the petals. See this? Petal, stamen. Petal, stamen. Petal, stamen. Petal, stamen. Okay. That means these stamens are arranged alternate to the petals. Then these petals are fused with themselves. These stamens are fused with the petals. These stamens are fused with the petals. Okay. Clear. In this diagram, these are the petals connecting with the petals. These are the stamens connecting with the petals. Okay, clear. This is stamens. What is the nature of the stamens in the Periplocaridae? Stamens are 5 in numbering. These stamens are alternative to the petals. These stamens are fused with the petals. That's why this phenomenon is called as epipetalous. Epi means stamens, above, ring is petals. Yes? So these stamens are fused with the petals. So that phenomenon is known as epipetalous. Again, in this stamens, anthers are dithecous. See this, dithecous anthers. Okay, this is slipter. Each and every anther is middle slipter, dithecous anther. These anthers are dithecous. Staminal tubes are free in arrangement. In this picture, LSR flower. This is LSR flower. This is LSR flower. In this LSR flower, we have to observe the see this picture. Okay, this is LSR flower. One, see this picture. These are the anthers. It is stigma. Okay, in this stamens, anthers are 5 numbering already shown in the diagram, floral diagram. Staminal tubes are free. In between the anthers or in between the staminal tubes, we have to observe the specialized structures in the periplocaridae and synenchaidae also. The structures are known as translators. Translators. These translators are, these are the translators. This entire structure is known as translator. Okay, this translator is located between the anthers or between the staminal tubes in the periplocaridae subfamily. This translator structure, when we will see the structure, translator of the periplocaridae, this translator is appearance like a spoon-like structure. This is spoon-like structure. In this translator, we observed two parts mainly. Those are the sticky part and stalk. Sticky part is, this is sticky part, it is stalk. Okay, sticky part is, this is sticky part. The sticky part is known as pollinium. Pollinium, nothing but group of pollen grains are known as pollinium. Group of pollen grains are formed as a gum ball like structure, that is known as pollinium. This entire part is known as pollinium. It is basal part of the translator. This pollinium is gum like structure because easily sticky of the insect feet to this gum like structure. When it is, the insect is a catching the nectar from the flower. Okay, this part is known as stalk. This is about the translator structure in periplocaridae subfamily. Then in this periplocaridae, pollen grains are formed in tetrods in formation. These tetrods are, when reached at translators, then pollen grains are sticked to pollinium. Once again, I will repeat this topic. Pollen grains are present in the pollinium. Yes, when these pollen grains are formed into tetrods in formation, when dehisce of the anther, when it, this entire part is present in the anther. Yes, this entire part is present in the anther. Yes, okay. When this anther is dehisce, inner side of this pollinium are reached at the translators. This translators pollen grains, in this translator pollen grains are sticked to the pollinium's sticky part. This is sticky part. Okay. This is about the periplocaridae characteristics. Now going to the translator mechanism. Translator mechanism in the periplocaridae. In periplocaridae pollination through the insects, this mechanism is translator mechanism. Translator mechanism means in two steps mechanism is done in the periplocaridae subfamily. In the first step, when insect is fall on the flower, the sticky part of the translator attaches to the back or body or head of the insect and translator comes out. Okay, then again when the insect is arrives the another flower, pollen tetrad in the translator reached the receptive spot of the stigma. In this way, this mechanism is occurs in the periplocaridae subfamily of Asclepiadaceae family. Through the translator mechanism is takes place in the periplocaridae. That's why this pollination mechanism is called as translator mechanism.